Hey, Phil here.
And,
the pecking, get it?
Wait, see that? That was Vischer Street and Nawrocki Avenue.
And Nawrocki Avenue.
It's pretty cool.
That named after
know.
Us, right?
Yeah.
Is that named after us or a different
so.
Vischer and Nawrocki?
Maybe that was the famous,
Boy, look at those buildings.
Leader.
Look at the lighting. Oh, before you watch this, you have to watch LarryBoy and The Fib from Outer Space so you can compare.
Yep.
Because we'd gone from, you know, maybe 25 people in the studio working on Fib from Outer Space, to now we were probably at 35 to 40, I think, right?
Yep. We had talked about layout before in the Fib from Outer Space.
We learned how to do layout now, so now nothing appears in a shot accidentally. You know ahead of time what's going to be in the shot, so you put the right amount of detail in it. So the buildings, the lighting, everything. And we had a real lighting department now, too.
Yep. And I was noticing the texture on the ground there, too, was nice.
Like chicken tracks going behind him.
From the pecking.
From the pecking. The film that's playing. Now, this was actually a scene here that I conceived for the first LarryBoy episode, but it made it too long, so I cut it. And then it went on this one. But this shot of Larry coming in and saying, "I'm LarryBoy.
I'm LarryBoy."
Kind of the inspiration for the whole Tim Burton Batman spoof.
Steps into light here.
Genre.
I believe you have something that belongs to those boys.
Well,
I think we had a 20 voice men's choir on Fib from Outer Space, and here this is a 80 voice men's choir.
LarryBoy.
The singing Norsemen.
Wow.
Holy mackerel. Full string section. This was by far the biggest score we'd ever done.
Yep. Well, the premiere for this, actually, we did at the Hard Rock Cafe in Orlando. And I just
that
remember...
That was fun.
Yeah, that was
Universal
really fun.
Universal City.
Yep. That was
Universal
really, really
Studios
cool.
Universal City Walk. That was
Take
fun.
Easy, fella. Don't get crazy.
So everything, every sky, I think, was painted by Joe Sapulich.
Those look like Sapuliches.
Yeah.
You can tell an authentic Sapulich.
In some cases, you were painting a sky just for one shot, which we had never done before. And we had to come up with that billboard so that it would make glory rays behind LarryBoy.
Makes sense, yeah.
Yeah.
That's a cool look for Jimmy.
And look at the logo. The logo for the police department.
Yep.
I don't know why we never put that on a t-shirt.
Yeah, that was pretty cool. Yeah, that's a good idea.
Do that.
Yeah.
Give me a t-shirt with that on it, somebody. Hello? Does anybody work here?
I'll buy one.
This shot, this is another Dan Lopez special.
This is a beautiful shot.
Spent a couple days just texturing that water tower.
But I love the transition there, how it comes around into the, mission control room.
See, I had kind of originally conceived this to be the last half-hour VeggieTales video, that we would never make another one, because we had now written Jonah, and we were ready to start making Jonah. So in my perfect plan in my brain, we would all then make films, feature films from now on.
Right. Yeah, well, this is very featuresque. I mean,
it
it's got
it on purpose.
Was on purpose, and then after this was Esther, which we kind of attempted to take up too, up another notch.
This is a fun backstory, establishing thing.
Yep.
Where did the villain come from? The creation of the villain.
Yep. Whenever people ask me what my favorite VeggieTales episode is, this one's always in my top three.
Whoa.
I like this one a lot.
What are the other two? I'm sure the people at home will want to know.
I like Madame Blueberry. It's a good one, too.
Yeah.
And, You know, the other one is a toss-up. Because I really like Little Joe a lot. Mm-hmm. Little Joe turned out great.
Yeah.
I like that a lot.
Yeah.
And I also liked show number... I think it was.
Okay.
I think that's what it was. Are you my neighbor? Yeah.
Okay. See, that was ironic because LarryBoy says, "If any more space aliens fall into Bumbleyburg, I'm ready for you." And he looks up in the sky, waiting for the bad guy to come, and the bad guy is underground.
Yeah.
Bad girl. Sorry.
Yep. Yep. Thinking it's another fib or something.
You always want your hero looking in the wrong direction, because that's funny. Now, you notice there was no theme song or countertop. Some people asked why, and it was because the first one, Fib from Outer Space, because it was so much more intense and dramatic than a typical VeggieTales episode, some people said, that's too scary for my kids. And so we wanted to differentiate this so they would know, okay, if you didn't like the first one, if you thought it was too scary for your kids, you're not going to like this one either. You know, and we wanted to make it look less like another VeggieTales episode. I actually thought about taking VeggieTales off the box.
Really?
And just having it be LarryBoy.
Oh, wow.
But that was going too far.
Yeah, that was going... Yeah, that wouldn't have been good.
Too far. So we did this, but we still wanted the verse at the end, so we had to figure out a way to do that.
Yep. It's a lot of black right here.
There is, but I thought it'd be interesting to hear someone talking about a chafing dish over black, so you have no context.
And it was.
Yeah, see?
There he is.
Made you laugh.
Wasn't that a great story, kids?
You know, I was watching something on TV. I think it was like SpongeBob or something. Yeah. And they had a robot episode where they're one of the SpongeBob thinks Squidward is a robot and he starts spreading a rumor about it.
Wow.
Couldn't believe it.
Really?
So I was honored that they would.
That can't be a coincidence.
Yep.
Can it? Remember, Alfred here represents the worst possible guest speaker at a first or second grade class. Because none of his stories are relevant to them. Now you'll notice we have much more detail on the buildings than the Fib from Outer Space. And when we go in tight, you'll see detail and dirt along the edges.
Yep.
So everything looks...
And more true to life, depth of field.
Oh, yeah, and the characters are... They've been recolored. Mm-hmm. All sorts of stuff has happened here. I mean, as big a leap as the first Larry Boy was, you know, from Where's God When I'm Scared?
Where's God When I'm Scared, yeah.
This was as big a leap again.
Yep.
From the first Larry Boy.
Yeah. And I think this is where we pretty much landed in terms of bar for, you know, half hour veggies after this.
We couldn't afford to go any higher.
That's right, yeah. We went higher with Jonah, but that was a different thing. Keep what
to yourselves. Now, this is Gail Freeman, who's done a bunch of voices for us over the years. And we did have some criticism as to why our gossipy character had to be a woman.
Oh, did we?
Yes, we did. Was that stereotyping, you know, again? It's like, you know, dad faints and we get complaints. Because, you know, men, a father shouldn't faint.
Yep.
So then we have a gossipy female character and we get complaints because that's stereotypical.
You can't make everybody happy.
But just so you know, we're not saying here that women are gossipy. We're actually, she was, we were parroting Joan Rivers.
Right.
The whole thing was a Joan Rivers spoof.
Yep.
And her persona of, can we talk? Can we talk?
Right.
So it wasn't about being, you know, a woman in general. Mm-hmm. It was about a woman in particular.
There you go.
Are you following me?
Yeah, I'm right there with you.
Okay.
Yep.
Because you're not looking at me. You're watching the show. So I don't know if you're paying any attention to what I'm saying at all.
I'm, I kind of figured where you were going, and then I got into the show.
And you kind of tuned out. Yeah, well, that's okay. Look, there's pebbles. See, along the crack line.
Yep.
You have to know that you're going to be pointing the camera at that spot to do that.
That's an exact reuse of the Fib from Outer Space shot.
That's the shot from the first show.
We just took it out and threw it right back in.
That, at a savings of millions of dollars. Now, this is pretty funny. A ball playing with a ball.
Poink.
Look at that bush.
Nice bushes.
That wasn't easy. Boy, I put that in the script, and they were worried.
I wonder how much geometry is in that bush cluster. It seems pretty
more
heavy.
Than in the first five shows put together, I think.
Man.
I don't think that bush was exceeded in geometric complexity until we got to the pirate ship in Jonah. See, but every time she pops up, she cleverly manipulates them into making the rumor actually weirder than before.
You know, as we were trying to lighten some of our models for shows after Jonah, I think I heard something like there was in the pocket of one of the characters in one of their costumes was the full pirate ship. The whole geometry for the pirate ship shrunken down and stuck in a character's pocket.
Get out of here. By accident, or
I don't know. I don't know. It could have been
corporate
sabotage. It could have been sabotage.
I'm going to staple pirate ships all over their characters.
They'll never be able to open this file.
The It's the perfect crime.
Those are pretty clouds.
Those are lovely clouds.
Yep.
I couldn't agree more, Alfred.
That's a pretty flower.
Yes. It was a little we had to tune down the color. I remember that.
We named a character in an upcoming episode Sweet, Sweet Petunia.
after that one. Uh-oh, it's a weed.
That's right. But did you hear
now, the idea for this, the whole show, well, actually, I had four writers that I was starting to work with for ideas. And this one came, and they sent in lots of very interesting ideas.
I'm sure.
Some rather bizarre. Mm-hmm. This one came from Doug Peterson, which was by far, I thought, the strongest in teaching and in potential for fun.
Well, you know, when I first saw the idea, I had, you know, my skepticism about it just because it felt a lot like The Fib from Outer Space, just in the story of the structure and everything.
Right.
It felt like the same story, but I think the way it played out, it, you know, it's great. I mean, I love it.
Yeah, it's a very similar teaching device.
Yeah.
Which, if you did that in every VeggieTales episode, would definitely get old.
That's right. But it really worked in this show.
You can't see it in the daytime. See, I mean, they never covered that in Batman. How do they call him during the day?
Yeah.
You can't see the signal. Am I the only person who's ever noticed that?
That's a nice looking Madame Blueberry right there. They did
a
great
look,
job.
Yeah, and look, we have a wonderfully strong, intelligent female mayor, and yet still they're griping because the villain is a lady. Oh man, I can't win for nothing.
Have another sip of mocha.
We're drinking coffee here to keep our energy up, because they have us locked in the booth recording three directors' commentaries in an hour and a half. Holy mackerel.
Look at that phone. That's a nice looking phone, isn't it?
Yeah, do you know why it's cordless?
Because cords are nothing but trouble.
Cords are nothing but trouble.
When we try to put ropes in our show, you might as well just take them out. We have a silly song in an upcoming episode, Sport Utility Vehicles, where they're at the pumps, you know, with pumping, you know, with their gas pumps in
do
their
they
car.
Have cordless pumps?
Cordless pumps. I just thought, it's not worth it. Just make it a prop device. I don't want to mess with lines. And you don't notice. I mean, it looks good. You know, it's fine.
This was an interesting song. I ended up liking the performance by the W's better than our own performance.
Oh, they both have their merit. I like them both.
Yeah.
Yeah, the W's did a great job on it, too.
Which you'll hear under the credits.
That's right.
If you haven't listened to this already.
And they played live at the premiere of this show in Orlando,
and that was
very, very cool.
That was fun. And then Nicole Mullen came out and did the theme song, LarryBoy theme song live, too.
That was one of our best premieres ever. I loved
that. What a party that was. You should have been there. Were you there? Maybe you were there, and I just don't recognize you because you're older or you shaved your beard off. I don't know.
You like that sound effect?
Yeah, where'd you get it?
I made it.
Did you do that with your mouth?
No, I didn't do that one with my mouth.
Let's hear it.
No, I didn't. I took like a chainsaw and sped it up, and then I did like a little like a flap, flap, flap of like some paper or something to get the little thing.
Yep. Wow, very impressive.
But I think John Waba did most of these. I think maybe I did that one. I remember doing that. I remember working on that sound effect.
Did we miss Dad Carrot showing up the first time? Yeah, we did. We missed Dad Carrot's first line.
Oh, yeah, the...
You're the library board. Robots that turn into teenagers.
That was John Waba, our editor, who's Egyptian. And we had open auditions in-house to see who wanted to be that role. And he made us laugh so hard that we had to cast him for the role, even if he was completely unintelligible. But that's what... you can turn on the little subtitles, and you can see
the
what
captions.
He actually said.
Yep.
For the first time now that this is out on DVD, you can see what he said.
Boom.
See, he couldn't cut it. It would have been... We couldn't actually show the attempted cutting, because that would have been a little...
I
don't know.
It's very Hitchcockian, you know? Just have it all happen off screen.
Yeah. I can't stop this thing. Ear down by the
weed. I'd like to have some of that on a t-shirt, too. I've installed sensors in your plungers that will tell us about genetic weed what? Analyzer?
Yeah.
Alfred's genetic weed
everything
analyzer.
Has to have a logo.
Yeah.
Everything.
Hello, hello. Testing 1, 2, 3.
Alfred, is it working?
Yes, yes. Perfect.
There's Junior down there on the screen there from Fib from Outer Space.
Oh, yeah, from Outer Space. That's right.
I'd love to, Alfred, but it got me by the ear.
What?
That's clever writing. It's got me by the ear. That's very nice.
Thanks. He doesn't have much else to hang on to, though, so I'm not sure I was trying to be clever. So now you notice we got multiple colors. I mean, we actually had color styling going on where they were laying out what color combinations to use for which parts. It was crazy. And I mean, more time went into just this song than the whole first two shows.
Man.
Better watch out for the rumor weed. It's kind of odd, though. The Mr. Nezer and the Egyptian Carrot singing back up on a big band song.
That's cool. It came off well. Did I have ever told you I bought a disco ball?
You bought a disco ball?
Yeah, I bought a disco ball.
What was the occasion?
Cool. Oh, we were having a little going-away party over at our house, and I bought a little disco ball for it.
Are you going away?
No, it's for somebody else.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
It doesn't photosynthesize.
Why do we care if it takes pictures?
See, get it? photo. Yeah. See, you can have so much fun when your superheroes kind of dim-witted. We need more dim-witted superheroes.
That's what the world needs more of.
Much more interesting. I'm not sure if they make good role models, but, you know. Where do
they get it? They're nice.
Yeah. They're more approachable. A dim-witted superhero.
Yeah.
Because very few people invite Superman over for dinner.
They're just intimidating.
He's intimidating.
Yeah.
What are you going to talk about?
Right.
Your lives have no commonality whatsoever.
That's right.
But Larry Boy, that's easy.
Yep.
You worry about him breaking things, though. That's an awfully nice graphic. Look at all those little pictograms.
Very cool. What was that Tom Cruise movie that he did with Steven Spielberg? The Minority Report?
Yeah, it's kind of my Minority Report
looking shot.
That's where they got the idea.
Yeah, because this predated Minority Report.
By years.
If Larry would have hands, you know, he'd be moving, you know, things around with his hands digitally.
And pulling out his eyeballs. That wouldn't be so good.
Nope.
See, it's just like Larry Boy to accidentally back into a joystick,
yep.
You know, and change the course of... the plot. Most superheroes change the course of the plot through their cunning. Larry Boy changes the course through his posterior. They're all connected.
Wow, it's really cool looking.
This was fun, the tension of this moment.
It could only be one thing.
Chuck in.
The mother weed.
The mother weed. Oh, here we go.
Oh, and I love how John did those little Larry Boy wipes
throughout the whole series.
Those are very, very cool.
The Larry Boy wipes. And the cave was designed by Aaron Hartline. I remember his drawings.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually, if you look at the schematic from overhead, it's the shape of Larry Boy's head.
Wow.
The layout of the cave.
Wow. Kind of like the Bible college we went to was in the shape of a cross.
Right.
Yeah.
Very similar. I think it was also designed by Aaron Hartline.
He was an old Jesuit.
Yeah.
Years back.
Off to the races. Now we got to keep the tension up from here on out. I mean, this is Larry Boy episodes are so different than a normal VeggieTales episode. You know, because the whole third act has got to be nonstop action.
Yep.
On a typical VeggieTales episode, you can get away with about, 30 seconds of action. And it carries it.
And it carries it, yeah.
But not Larry Boy.
Not Larry Boy.
No. And I remember when we started out, Dan Lopez decided he wanted to completely rebuild the Larrymobile.
Oh, yeah.
Remember that?
Yeah, I remember that.
Oh, man, I think he worked for a month on this.
Oh, man.
That sucker. I mean, the leather upholstery on the inside, you know, every button, the speakers right behind his head.
Yep.
Holy mackerel.
He could got a job with General Motors after this, I think.
And those night lights that are going to light up. Yeah, see, that was all built in from the get-go. Here comes the boring machine.
Nobody knew what I meant by that. So it's like a compound drill bit that you see on a big mining machine.
Yeah, yeah.
And everybody said, what does that look like? So they had to go look it up on the internet.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, this was fun. And they put some jokes in there, didn't they? They put some, there were like some bones or spare tires or things in the dirt behind him.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, I remember somebody showing me frame by frame.
Okay.
But I don't know if you could actually see it when it was all done.
Yeah.
You're boring. Oh, is that funny? Oh, man. I laugh every time I hear that.
I see.
He's really sounding like Larry now.
Oh, yeah. He's losing the lisp. That's a nice shot.
Yeah.
Little fisheye action. Okay, so this must have been where the tires were and stuff.
Yeah, in here somewhere there's some hidden stuff. It took a long time to figure out how big the rock should be in the foreground to make it look like he was underground.
Right.
You know, that was a pain. Now this sequence, when we're actually underground, is when we started rendering in Mental Ray, which is a different, much higher quality renderer than the standard renderer, the soft image renderer. So these shots underground are the best looking shots in any VeggieTales video ever. Because it was the only time we could use Mental Ray.
Oh, yeah.
But look at that. Like, do you know how much time went into putting all the dents and stuff on the
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Holy mackerel.
Alfred, can you hear me?
It's a thing of beauty.
Yep.
The radio isn't working.
The sewer walls must be blocking the transmission.
See, they're both realizing at the same time. They're thinking simultaneously and identically, finishing each other's thoughts without knowing because they can't talk to each other. Uh-oh. Complete reversal. The helper of the hero must become the hero to help the hero. How heroic.
To help the helpless hero. But, and his little scooter. Like his little umbrella there.
And that's now his theme, which was established when he was in the classroom.
It'd have been funny if he would have fallen over on his scooter as he dropped out.
That would have been funny.
After all, a superhero.
A superhero. I am a Oh, it's just a little one.
We've gotten rid of our faceting here.
Oh, yeah.
Well, our curves are smooth for the most part.
For the most part. Here comes the mother weed. We were a little worried about that scaring the kids.
Yeah.
You okay, kids?
Mother!
That breaks it up.
Yeah, yeah.
It's all about breaking it up.
It's okay if the scared hero says something funny while being scared.
Yep.
Then it tells everyone that it's okay.
I like Scooter out here eating a donut.
See, the rumor has spread so far that he can't get any help. So that's how dangerous rumors are. He can't get help. He needs help. He can't get help because the rumor has undermined his credibility. See, kids, you need to avoid spreading rumors because you never know when you're going to need the police to believe you that your friend is battling a giant weed in the sewer system, and they're not going to believe you because they heard you were a robot.
That's a solid piece of advice.
A dangerous
right there.
Robot.
That's right.
You're connected. See, double meaning. There are so many double meanings in this. It's just...
If you do say so yourself.
I've forgotten about all this.
Yeah, it's
this
a nice
a good show.
Yeah, see? Especially after watching Where's God When He Wants Me to Forgive Them and I'm Scared. I don't know what that was.
Where's God When We Don't Have the Time or Money to Make Another Show? I think that was the name of that show. At one point, I was then going to have him drop down on his knees and try to blow the powder on her. But then I thought that might look too much like he was trying to snort the powder.
Oh, no,
and,
that'd be
know,
bad.
That'd be bad. You can't go there. And oh, here's our crowd scene. Assemble the crowd. And this is the first rule of veggiedom.
That looks like John Waba right there.
Yeah.
Our editor.
If you want to fill up some space in a veggie crowd, call in the pumpkin.
And the mushrooms.
And the mushroom kids.
With an eerie lack of chroma. They're completely gray. The mushrooms.
Mushrooms, really?
Yeah.
Like the M&Ms that lost their colors?
Yeah, see, they're just no... I mean, they should be like a little blue or something.
Yeah.
You know?
Look, got something spinning on the sign again.
Is that the cow?
No, it's not the cow. It's something flying around the giant chicken.
Oh, that's a nice logo for the city of Bunkerburg.
Man. I want that on a t-shirt, too.
I think it's the same logo that was on the cop car, just not colored.
Yeah, all right. Don't look at his eyes. Now this, I'm worried that this score got a little too off-putting, a little too intense for kids, because it's a mix of your classic psycho strings with some of the themes we had established, and it's a little frightening. Look at that transition. Did you see that?
Oh, that's real nice.
Tilt up into the sky, into dirt, and come up in the sewer. That was not easy. That was not easy.
Let me tell you.
Man. Oh, look, he got beat up, so he has bandages on his head. Because that's what happens in the cartoons. If you get hit, there's a bandage on you automatically just from getting hit.
Just from getting hit.
And yep. Even his latex, he has a black eye on his latex. See, that's actually the first time in the movie that Larry Boy has heard there's a rumor about Alfred.
Mm-hmm.
So all that
first
time
he'd listen
yep.
to it, yeah.
That's
some nice stonework right there.
Here we see what he said.
Oh,
was,
yeah, there
I heard there are
inside
teenagers inside him that know karate.
Yep.
See, it was a Power Rangers reference. Nobody got that because they couldn't understand him, man.
But we know.
We know, and we thought it was funny just because it was Egyptian sounding. And it was our friend John.
That's right.
There's the mushroom family that's come from a black and white film. Need to call up Ted Turner and have them colorized. I'm not shaking it. See, the earthquake starts, and they say the robot's shaking the world.
Did you notice she loses her lipstick in that shot?
Really?
Yeah, her lips are just green.
Wow.
And then her lipstick is back in this shot. I remember that. Wow. It was a render crunch, and we couldn't get it rendered in time.
And she's kind of twitchy here. You'll notice she's a little twitchy because they couldn't fix
the twitch.
She kept twitching, kind of like the old Grapes of Wrath jalopy.
That's right.
It's a big weed, Dad.
Look at all those light bulb lights up there. Holy cow.
Yeah, somebody had to build every one of those by hand. They were hand-blown. Look at the robots, the weeds playing with the car.
That was a Ron Smith special right there.
Yeah, look, it's way
that's totally Ron Smith.
Isn't that funny?
Yep.
That was not in the script. Sometimes the animators make up their own stuff.
I can't get enough of that stonework on the ground there. I went... Get the name of that mason. Have him out to my house.
Yeah, that's nice stuff. Very reliable. Look, she's twitching.
Yep, there she goes.
Help me. I'm a little nervous. Uh-oh. You were behind all this? See, both of these shows, both the Larry Boys, show how something that a child does can grow.
Right.
You know, in unexpected and unwanted directions.
Yep.
Certain consequences.
Yes.
Right.
Right.
They're really valuable lessons to
you
kids.
See?
You see. Oh, boy. Sometimes there's not enough caffeine in the world.
He really meant that he was tired and needed to go home and rest. Yeah, you do have a lot more energy for this one than you did for the last one, I'm noticing.
Yeah.
I've kind of maintained an even keel through the thing.
Oh, well, aren't you something special? I guess you should just do these by yourself from now on.
No, I'm not saying that's any better.
Mr. Moderation. Man. Nothing sweeter than a nice lesson from Dad Asparagus.
That's right.
It just goes down so smooth.
Like a mocha, right?
Yeah, but not caffeinated.
Like
more
a decaf mocha.
A sedative mocha. Oh, nice words make weeds bloom into flowers.
This really freaked me out the first time I saw this flower's head explode. I think I audibly screamed. I'm like, ah! But I've grown to like it.
Oh, I'm glad for that.
Yep, yep. It felt very Scanners to me.
I didn't like that line very much.
What's that? What line?
It says, come on, let's spread nice words. That just... Sounds
if she had a basket of pansies when she said it, you know, it would have been nice.
Yeah, the idea was right. What's behind them? Is that a Japanese restaurant?
I don't know. I didn't notice that.
Yeah, Japanese writing on the site. Bake sale! Uh-oh, that's trouble.
Mm.
I'm twitching over that.
Twitching.
You're making me... And he smiles, and Kurt put little bells on that smile.
That's ding, very nice.
Ding.
Kurt does a lot of that now with eye blinks and stuff. He has nice little bells and little highlights he does for that.
Here we go.
Okay, kids.
This is the payoff.
Don't be shocked.
Look at that.
I replay my first expression to this. Here it comes. Ah!
What? The metaphor works. Oh, and you get to slide down your rumor. I'm not sure what that means, metaphorically. If you come clean, your rumor turns into a big slide, and you'll love it.
You can only take metaphors so far.
We should have had the mushroom family burst into color.
Yeah. Like Smallville.
Pleasantville.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Smallville. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Don't rent that movie, kids. Not for you.
No. Nope.
Not really for anyone, frankly.
Come to think of it.
Oh, yeah. What happened to Larry Boy? Oh, I see the choir asked that question.
Mm-hmm.
Where is Larry Boy?
Like a little fishing pole.
But he starts to spread a rumor.
Somebody told me you were a robot.
My wife didn't like that. She said, they should not shush him. That's mean.
Oh, but I said no. They wanted... It was lovingly shushed.
Yeah, they're very concerned about... Mm-hmm. And they said, this is their flower show. Get it? That's funny.
Oh,
man.
That's nice.
Here comes... See, man, when you can have an 80-voice men's choir sing the end for the end of your film, you feel like a filmmaker. You know?
That's the way to end it. And
it's
send
one
them
thing to just type the end on a little, you know.
Now, didn't Robert Ellis do this
yes.
ending animation in like
yes.
3 days?
Yeah, he had to do it all by himself in very little time.
Yep.
Because we still needed to get our Bible verse in, but we didn't want to go back to the countertop because we were breaking away from that metaphor.
Yeah.
Breaking away.
Take a look at this.
Reckless words. So that's a whole verse. Like a we had a lot of half verses coming up.
See, this is, you know, this is a nice updated QWERTY look right there.
Yeah, well, that's not QWERTY. That's so not, that's the Larry Cave computer. Larry computer.
He's probably networked to QWERTY, though, I would think.
Maybe. Wireless? Wi-Fi?
Yeah, could be.
Maybe.
100 base T connection.
Although I don't think QWERTY is Wi-Fi compatible. QWERTY still has a 5-inch floppy.
He had an expansion chassis though, didn't he? Remember,
God doesn't want us to tell stories that. For some reason, Archibald looks huge in these shots. I think it's because he was standing in front of Larry Boy.
Yeah.
He was.
Yep. Dot. Oh.
There he goes.
Excuse me.
Oh, here's the
W
song.
Here come the W's.
They did a really good job with this song.
Yeah, I like their version better than my version. But I guess that's good, because if you hire somebody to do a version and you like it worse than your version, then you wouldn't want to pay them. So, you know, they
well
earned
put.
Their money. Thanks. Man, there are a lot of names in this one.
I like the font for the credits. That's
bum,
nice.
Bum, bum, yeah, now we had a design department that would say things like, hey, why don't you do your credits in this font that we're using for the marketing campaign? And we'd say, font? What is a font? Because videographers only know about Helvetica. That's all we know. And sometimes we underline it, and sometimes we italicize it. But
or make
all
it all
know.
Caps and lower, upper, lower.
Yeah, and then you hire designers, and they you know, come walking with these giant books of fonts. And
although, Palatino, that was our favorite one.
Dan O'Brien was in charge of all that lighting and special effects, and he just did an amazing job.
Yep.
We've got three people doing matte paintings. Holy mackerel. A director of technical development. We've never had one of those before.
Software development.
Digital asset management. Man.
Sound effects. John Wabla.
This one was out of control.
A lot of actors in this one, too.
A lot of our kids came in. Oh, Shelby was one of the school kids. That's my daughter.
Yep.
This was probably the best score for a half-hour VeggieTales video, except for Jonah.
Mm-hmm.
It was, Kurt went kooky on this one.
Yeah.
That's why this is the only one that really made us want to put out a soundtrack album.
Yeah.
Which we did.
Yep. Yeah, we had
did a, you buy enough... it? You should buy it. It's good stuff.
It is very good.
And Mike wrote poems for it, which are the best part.
Oh, yeah, the
goal.
Oh, yeah, I remember writing those poems. That was fun.
Yeah, go check it out.
That was nice.
You can probably buy it on eBay by now.
He's rumor.
Rumor weed. My little sorry. It's 1999.
Yep. Doesn't seem
like
that.
Where were you in 1999? What did we do for the APOP?
Suction cup. Yep.
Yep.
Got it. All right. Good night, everybody.
Good night, everybody. Drive safe.